Guys, ay okay na pala nagre-record na. Guys, let us just wait for Ma'am Uy. Ma'am Uy is switching from laptop to mobile, kaya antayin lang natin saglit.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay po, sir.
Okay po, sir.
Commercial muna, commercial.
Kanta ka na, sir.
Trill.
Kanta ka na,
Trill. Shout out,
Happy birthday, Trill.
Ano ang kakantahin ko?
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Sir Ken, hindi ako maka-join. Sir Ken, hindi ako maka-join dun sa ano. Sa... Wait lang.
Anong lumalabas, ma'am?
Naiiba yung code. Nakakainis naman.
Wait lang, sandali.
Wait lang. Try po ulit. Sandali lang, class, ha?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, ma'am. Mamaya, huwag na, naka-record. Maririnig yung boses ko na maganda. Pang The Voice.
Sige, Seren, kanta ka na.
Pang The Voice.
Ayaw mo yun, madi-discover ka.
Loki lang dapat, Loki.
Okay na ba, ma'am?
Ma'am, nakamute po, ma'am.
Nakamute.
Okay, so I'm back. Can you see my paper?
Yes, ma'am.
So, ito.
Yes, ma'am.
We have here a polynomial. We call this polynomial because we have here variable x and a constant number. And we call this a number. Okay? So, we can call this a rational number. This one. Kasi, pwede rin siyang magkaroon ng denominator. This is just equal to 3 over 1. Okay, so this one now is in rational form. Okay, pero rational din po ito kasi may denominator siyang 1. Invisible lang. Maliwanag po ba?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear? Yes, ma'am. Yes, same with this. So x plus 1, pwede po siyang magkaroon dyan ng denominator na 1. Kaya we can call this a rational function as well. So, yung mga numbers natin, mapa-whole numbers man po yan, pwede po yan maging rational number. Same with the polynomials. Kahit wala pong denominator dyan, we can consider that rational function pa rin. Kasi we can just put 1 sa denominator. Klaro po ba? Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so nakikita niyo ba ako? Nagfi-feedback ako. Okay, nagfi-feedback ba ako, class? Dalawa yung screen ko. Sorry. Okay. So, nagfi-feedback ako. Pero narinig ba ako na maayos?
Opo, ma'am.
Yes, alright. So, let's go back sa aking presentation. So, yun yung mga tinatawag nating rational functions. Okay, let's move on. So, siya. Ito lang din yung explain ko kanina. But how do we read this? Sabi niya, every polynomial function is a rational function. Just like the one I showed you. Okay? So, the domain of R is written in the form of domain R, si R po, that is rational, okay, is equal to X such that X is an element of real number except C. Si C na tinutukoy niya po dyan is yung number na kapag sinubstitute natin siya sa equation ng denominator, magiging zero. Okay, just like this one. Let's say x plus 1 over x plus 2.
Nakikita niyo po ba?
Yes, ma'am.
Nakikita niyo ba yung ano ko? Yung screen,
yes,
I mean, yung notebook ko?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
yes. Okay. So ito, lahat ng real numbers pwede except ano kaya ilalagay natin kay X? So substitute natin kay X na pag nilagay natin magiging zero itong denominator. X is
yung opposite po ng number.
Negative 2.
Negative
2. 2.
So ibig sabihin X should not be equal to negative 2. So si negative 2 siya po yung tinutukoy na C. Na hindi siya pwedeng i-substitute dito kasi magiging 0 ito. Kapag naging x plus 1 over 0, ano pong tawag dito?
Undefined.
Very good. Magiging undefined na po ito. So, hindi na po siya magiging rational function. Maliwanag?
Yes po.
Yes. Okay. So, let's have here yung na-example na binigay ko kanina. So, for rational function, we have intercepts, zeros, and asymptotes. We will define that in the next slide. So, when we say intercept, ano po ang intercept? Based on your own understanding, what is intercept? Sino pong may idea?
Ano ba yan?
Pakimute po muna. Kung hindi po sasagot muna, pakimute po muna ng ating mga audio. Thank you. Okay, so sino pong may idea about intercepts? I want to hear from your own idea. Ma'am, yung intercept yun po yung nagko-cross sa line sa graph. Very good. So when we say intercept, parang sa mga kalsada rin, we have intersection, di ba? Yung nag-i-intersect sila. So pag sa intercept naman class, yun yung tatamaan, tinatamaan sa graph. Okay, let's say I have a graph here. Okay, when we say intercept, pag naggawa ako ng graph dito, andito siya. Okay, na-intercept niya dito, sa bandang to, kay x-axis. Maliwanag po ba? So, ito yung tatawagin natin, x-intercept. Claro?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. So, same with y-intercept. Ganun din po siya. And what about kay zeros? So, zeros daw po ay yung mga values which makes the whole function zero. So, kung ano po yung lumabas kay x, dito sa x-intercept, siya rin po ang i-consider natin zero. Next, for asymptotes. What is asymptote? I'm sure na-discuss na sa inyo ang asymptote. Okay? Kapag asymptote class, yan po yung line, or pag sinabi ang asymptote, line po yun na hindi matatouch. Okay? Hindi siya matatouch ni graph. As in, never silang magtatouch. Very close, yet never touch. Okay? So yan po ang asymptote. Okay, so let's have here the x-intercept. As I said earlier, ganito po siya. Ordered pair x, 0. For y-intercept, 0y naman. Kapag kay x-intercept class, always remember, si x lang po ang hahanapin natin. Si y, automatic, 0 na po siya. And for y-intercept, siya lang, si y lang po ang hahanapin natin, kaya automatic, 0 po si x. Para hindi po kayo malito. Alright, so let's go muna kay x and y-intercept. Medyo bilisan lang natin class. Andito, nilagay ko dito sa aking paper. Okay, so ito siya. Nakikita niyo po ba? Class, nakikita niyo po ba? Please respond para
yes, mag-ibig
tayo. Okay, so this is the function, rational function. I have an example here, 5x plus 16 over x plus 4. How do we find the x-intercept? For x-intercept, nilagay ko na po dito x0, ordered pair x0. May value na po si y, so si x
po ang
hahanapin natin. Ayan. Nakikita niyo ba?
Hindi po, ma'am. Hindi po, ma'am.
Hindi po.
Malabo. Nasa kabilang screen po ni ma'am.
Ah,
nasa
okay.
Kabilang screen ni ma'am.
Malabo po.
Stop sharing. Ayan.
Ma'am, maalino na po.
Okay na?
Po ma'am, opo.
Okay. So, ayan na siya. I have here an example. F of x is equal to 5x plus 16 over x plus 4. Okay. So, si x-intercept, that is the ordered pair of x and 0. Wala pa rin daw sa iba. Baka may problema po sa internet. Nakikita ko naman sa screen ko. Nakikita ba ng iba? Okay, let me off this. Ayan, meron na? Hi.
Tingnan niyo po sa phone screen ni ma'am.
Yes, nasa phone screen naman. Nakikita ko naman siya dito sa laptop ko, sa screen.
Wala po, ma'am.
I-click niyo po yung screen kong isa. Dalawa po kasi yung screen ko diyan.
Kahit naka-pin na po, wala pa rin.
Wala yes, pa rin, ma'am.
Wala pa rin po, ma'am.
Ayan, okay na?
Okay, guys, rejoin.
Yes, okay, ma'am.
Meron na, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, so
ma'am,
dito
meron na po, ma'am.
Alright, going back, ito yung aking example. For x-intercept, ordered pair po siya ni x and 0. So, looking at the ordered pair, mayroon na pong value si y, which is 0. So, automatic, si f of x, palitan nyo lang po yan ng y. Okay? And same equation. So, si y, 0 na siya. As you can see here, sa ordered pair natin, 0 si y. So, isa-substitute lang po natin. 0 is equal to 5x plus 16 over x plus 4. Cross-multiply, automatic, anything multiplied by 0 is always 0. So, naging 0 na po yun. Hindi ko na cross-multiply. I mean, hindi ko na sinulat ng isahan. So, automatic 0 na po yan. Okay, so 0 is equal to 5x plus 16. And then, transpose, ilipat po natin si 16, naging negative 16 equals 5x. Divide both sides by 5 para maiwan po si x. We now have x is equal to negative 16 over 5. The result here, class, we can consider that si 0 na. Automatic, lagyan nyo na yan, 0. Okay, ito na yung i-consider nating 0 for this function. Okay, and we have here the ordered pair. Susulat nyo lang po ulit. Negative 16 over 5 and si 0. Ayun siya. So, ito na po si x-intercept natin. Dito siya tatama yung line. Okay, next, for y-intercept. Y-intercept, lagi nyo po isulat yung ganitong form. 0, y. So, si x, automatic, 0 na. Kasi nandito na siya. Nakalagay na siya kay 0. Alright, so ayun na siya. Si y naman ang hahanapin natin, si x naman ay equal to 0. Substitution, lagay natin si 0 dyan, 0, 0. 0 times 5 is still 0. So 16 plus 4, if you divide that, that will be equal to 4.
20.
We now have, ha? Anong 20? May nalil akong 20. So 16 over 4, that is 4. We now have here the ordered pair for y-intercept, and that is 0, 4. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Yes. Next, let's have the asymptotes. Pakita ko na lang sa inyo dito sa laptop ko. Okay, so we're done with the intercepts and 0. Let's go to the asymptotes. Okay. We have three asymptotes. We have vertical, horizontal, and slant. Or we sometimes call that oblique. Okay, so tatlo yan. How do we determine kung horizontal siya, vertical, or slant? Ganito lang po yan, class. Ito na lang tignan nyo sa paper ko. Vertical, kapag pwede mo siyang may makukuha kang value ni x na mag-equate sa 0. If you equate the denominator to 0, dapat may makukuha kang answer ni x. Okay, I will show you later kung paano yan. Next, dito lang po tayo sa degree titingin, sa highest degree. Okay, dito, ano po ang highest degree niya? Sa numerator.
1 po.
1 ito, si 5x. Ang highest degree niya is 1. Sa numerator,
1 din.
1 din po.
1 din. text lang. Okay, so titingin kayo dito. Degree of numerator, degree ng numerator dito sa taas should be less than or equal sa degree ni denominator para masabi mong may horizontal asymptote. Okay? Kapag naman slant asymptote, kailangan ang degree po ni numerator ay greater than sa degree ni denominator by 1. Isa lang dapat ang pagitan nila. Let's say we have here x squared plus x plus 3 over x cubed plus x plus 7. Saan po siya kabilang? Pakitignan. Vertical, horizontal, slant.
Horizontal.
Saan po siya kabilang?
Vertical, horizontal,
horizontal
po.
Or horizontal po.
Horizontal. Horizontal po. Kasi ang highest degree dito is?
Denominator.
Dito naman, 3. So, 2, 3. This is for numerator, this is denominator. Sino ang mas malaki? Numerator, denominator?
Denominator.
Denominator.
Denominator. So, less than. N is less than D dapat. Horizontal. So we can consider this horizontal. May horizontal asymptote to. Maliwanag po ba?
Opo.
Clear? Okay, I think yes. That's clear. Okay, so nakikita niyo ba yung screen ko ng maayos? So as you can see, kay vertical asymptote, ayan. Si denominator lang po ang kukunin natin. Magpo-focus tayo kay denominator. So si denominator, i-equate lang po natin.
Ma'am, malabo.
Wait lang, i-rewrite ko po sa paper. Bilisan lang natin to class. So vertical. Vertical asymptote. VA na lang po ilagay ko ha. F of x is equal to 3x squared plus 2x plus 1 over x minus 2. So, kay vertical asymptote, dito lang po tayo magpo-focus kay denominator. Okay, so kunin natin yan. X is minus 2 is equal to 0. I-equate natin siya kay 0. Okay, so X now is equal to, ano po ang X?
2.
Positive 2, ma'am.
So, ito na po si vertical asymptote. Dito po tatama ang ating vertical asymptote. Na kay 2. Kumbaga sa graph, ito siya. We have here 1 and then we have here 2. So dito po tatama ang ating asymptote. Ayan. Sorry, hindi siya tumama. Ayan. Ayan. So andito na si asymptote. Maliwanag po ba? So might be nandito yung dalawang graph natin. Okay, baka andyan yan, yung dalawang graph. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So, in case class, let's say for example, h of x is equal to 2x over x squared plus 1. Okay? So, let's try to see kung may vertical asymptote ba to. Kay denominator lang po tayo magpo-focus. So, yan is magiging x squared plus 1 equals 0. So, x squared is equal to, ano dito sa kabila?
Negative 1.
Okay. Extract the root. Ayan. Cancel, cancel. Matitira is x is equal to square root of 1. Ano pong lumalabas kapag nag-square root tayo ng negative numbers?
Imaginary.
Ha? This is imaginary. Magiging imaginary po yan. Ibig sabihin, hindi possible. Therefore, no vertical asymptote. Clear?
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes, sumagot kayo, class. Okay? Uso po mag-ano ngayon, unmute. Alright, wow. Let's go to horizontal asymptote. Kay horizontal asymptote, class, there are three things to consider. First, kapag ang ating numerator, degree ni numerator, ay equal sa degree ni denominator, ang gagawin po natin, kukunin lang po natin yung kanilang coefficients. For example, we have here 3x cubed plus 2x squared plus 1. let's see ha, over 6x cubed plus 3x. Ayan. So, ano po ang highest degree natin sa denominator?
3.
Ito siya. Class, ang tinutukoy ko pong degree ito, exponent. Ayan. Yan po yung tinutukoy kong degree. Okay? So, 3. Sa baba, ano ang highest degree dito sa baba?
3.
Lang 3. So, ang gagawin po natin, kukunin lang po natin ito. Okay, so our y now is equal to 3 over 6. Bakit naman po y ang ginamit ko dito kay horizontal asymptote instead of x? Bakit y? Bakit po y?
Kasi horizontal po yung axis po nung...
Very good. Kasi horizontal po siya. So, doon siya kay y tatama. Obviously, kay y siya tatama. Kasi horizontal nga siya eh. So, ganun siya. So, lahat ng tama niya ay kay y. Kaya y is equal to 3 over 6 or that is equal to
1/2.
So, this is our horizontal asymptote. Dito po siya tatama. Maliwanag?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes po.
Okay, so for second case naman, kapag ang numerator po natin, degree of our numerator is less than the degree of our denominator. Okay, let's say for example, we have here f of x is equal to, gamitin na rin lang natin to, 3x cubed plus 2x squared plus 1 over 6x raised to 7 plus 3x. Ano po ang highest degree sa numerator? That is?
3.
Okay. So, dito naman kay numerator, we have?
7.
7. So, si 3 is less than 7. At therefore, ang magiging intercept po natin dyan, I mean asymptote, ay nakay 0. Automatic na kay 0 po. Aliyanag, wala nang computation dyan. Automatic 0 na po yan. Klaro?
Yes, ma'am.
Klaro. Next. For the third case naman, kapag ang ating degree ni numerator is greater than the degree kay denominator, okay, let's use the same example. Let's say f of x is equal to 3x, baliktarin ko lang, raised to 7, plus 2x squared plus 1, over 6x raised to 3, plus 3x. Okay, so anong degree ni denominator? That is 7.
7.
Okay, numerator 3. So 7 is greater than 3, therefore, no horizontal asymptote po yan. Maliwanag?
Yes po, ma'am.
Yes po.
Yes po.
Last, hindi tayo mag-move on kapag walang sasagot. Okay? Kaya masumagot po kayo. Okay. Let's have slant asymptote. No question so far? Kay vertical tsaka kay horizontal?
Yes po, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. So, let's go kay slant asymptote. Kay slant asymptote naman po, ang tatandaan nyo lang, degree of numerator should be greater than ba? Wait lang. Let's see yung isinulat ko dito. Okay, so greater than. Greater than kay degree ni denominator. Okay, by 1. Class, isa lang po dapat ang difference nila. Let's say this one, f of x is equal to 3x cubed plus 2x squared plus 1 over 6x squared plus 3x. Plus 3x. So this one, since isa lang po ang difference ni degree natin, highest degree, we can say that this has a slant asymptote. So how are we going to get this slant asymptote? Okay, we use the so-called long division.
Division.
Marunong na ba kayo ng long division?
Yes, po.
Yes, yes. So, do I need to discuss long division or we can move on na po?
Hindi pa po alam.
Hindi pa alam ng marami. Okay. So, let's have this one. Yung nasa example na natin. Okay, 2x cubed plus 5x squared plus 1 over x squared plus x plus 3. Okay, so ang gagawin natin, parang normal division rin lang yan, class. Plus 5x squared plus 1 divided by x squared plus x plus 3. So parang normal division lang din po. Ito muna. 2x cubed divided by dito. Anong kalalabasan? This one divided by this. Si first lang po ang i-divide natin.
Oh, hindi po makita, ma'am.
Ay, sorry. Okay. Divide. 2x cubed divided by x squared. Ano pong kalalabasan?
2x.
2x. 2x. 2x. 2x.
Okay, next. Since pangmaramihan po yan, hindi lang yan iisang numero, maglagay po tayo dito ng parenthesis. Okay, di ba nagsosubtract po tayo dyan? Tama po ba?
Yes, ma'am.
Opo.
The multiplication. Normal division lang po ito, ha? 2x times x squared. That is 2x raised to?
3.
X times x. That is?
2x squared.
2x squared. Tama po ba?
Yes, po. Yes, po.
Next. 2x squared. That is?
6x.
6x. Wala 6x. Siyang katapat dito, ha? Wala siyang katapat. Huwag niyo po siyang itatapat kay 1. Okay? So, wala siyang katapat. Andyan siya. Yan. Since naka-parenthesis po yan, si negative dito, kailangan niyo siyang i-distribute sa lahat. Okay? I-distribute niyo po yan sa lahat. So, dito, magiging negative na to. Negative. Okay? So, negative times positive, that is negative. Negative times positive is still negative. So, ayan na siya. Naintindihan?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. So, this one, maka-cancel na yan. Cancel, cancel. Kasi 2x cubed minus 2x cubed, 0 na po yan. This one, 5x cubed minus, naging negative na po ha, minus 2x squared.
3x squared.
Magiging positive, negative.
Positive.
Negative.
Positive
3x squared. Kasi plus 5, positive 5x, negative 2x. Okay? Next, ito, wala siyang katapat. So, ibaba lang natin.
Bring down.
X. Tapos si 1, i-bring down din natin. Plus 1. Okay, next. Ito naman, 3x squared divided by x squared.
3x.
Magiging 3x ba?
3 lang.
Plus 3. Magiging 3 na lang yan, class. Okay, same thing. Lagyan natin ng parenthesis dito. Minus. 3 times x squared.
3x squared.
3 times x.
3x.
3x.
Okay, next. 3 times 3.
3.
9.
Anong 3? Plus 9. Okay. So, distribute nyo po si negative dito. This is magiging negative, magiging negative, magiging negative. Okay. So, makakancel na to. Cancel, cancel, 0. Negative 6x minus 3x.
Negative
9. 1 minus
9. 8. Negative 8.
Negative 8.
So, see? Remainder. Remainder po yan, okay? This is now our slant asymptote. Ayan. Kaya yan ganyan, class. Hindi yan whole number. Kasi pag ganito po yan, oh. Pag ganyan. So, hahanapin nyo pa siya. So, dito, pag nakuha nyo yung slant asymptote niya, magbigay kayo ng values ni x. Okay? Magbigay kayo ng values ni x and then hanapin nyo si y. Parang ganito siya. For slant asymptote, okay, y is equal to 2x plus 3. So, magbibigay lang kayo ng values ni x. Let's say si x is negative 4, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1. Okay, next, using the values of x, mahahanap nyo po si values ni y. Substitute nyo lang po itong mga to dito para mahanap nyo si y. And then pag enough nyo yan, ganito po ang kalalabasan. Maliwanag?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. So let's go to day 5. So our day 5 class is solving real-life problems involving rational functions. Actually, ginagamit lang naman natin siya kay work problems. Okay, kay work problems lang po natin siya ginagamit. Usually, ha? Okay. So, let's have here examples. Alright. Sabi niya dito, Jose takes 15 minutes and Pedro takes 60 minutes for one newspaper. Okay. So, sabi niya, si Jose daw, ilang oras inaabot si Jose?
15 minutes.
So, that is 15 minutes. Dito tayo. 15 minutes. Okay. Sino yung isa? Si Pedro. Si Pedro, inaabot daw siya ng 60 minutes. So, anong tinatanong nila? Anong tinatanong?
Kung gaano katagal
how long
will it take when they work together? Okay. Oh. Jose, 15 minutes. Iisang trabaho lang po yung ginagawa nila, ha? Same work. So, ang hinahanap is work together. Okay, so that is X. Kasi hindi pa natin alam kung ilang oras. So, ang gagawin ninyo, paano ba malalaman? Kapag nagtatrabaho kayo, di ba, i-add nyo lang yung oras para malaman ninyo kung gaano kabilis kapag dalawa na kayo ang nagtatrabaho. Okay, so ang gagawin, since iisa lang naman po yung work, 1 over 15. Ayan, dito yung minute. Ito yung work, ito yung oras. Plus, one work, 60 minutes equals 1 over X. Work together. So, kunin nyo lang po yung LCD nitong dalawa. Anong LCD ng 15 tsaka 60?
60.
60. So, divisible sila po by 60. Okay, 60 divided by 15?
4.
4. Okay. Times 1 is still 4. 60 divided by 60 is 1. Times 1 is equal to 1 pa rin. Equals 1 over X. 4 plus 1, obviously 5 over
60.
1 over X. Next, ang gagawin nyo class, cross-multiply lang po. Ayan, cross-multiply. So, magiging 5X is equal to
60.
Divided by 5. By 5. So, X now is equal to?
6.
1 over 8.
60 divided by 5.
12 na.
12. So, ibig sabihin, kapag dalawa na silang gagawa ng trabaho, aabutin lang sila ng 12 minutes. Maliwanag?
Yes, ma'am.
Maliwanag?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Dito naman tayo kay pipe. Okay, so sabi niya dyan, one pipe fills the storage pool in 20 hours. The second pipe, 15 hours. Okay? So, next. Sabi niya, when third pipe is added, all three used to fill the pool. It takes only 6 hours. So, first pipe, ilang oras? First pipe?
20.
20 hours. Second pipe?
15
hours. Third pipe?
Yun yung hinahanap.
Oh, missing. So, siya yung hinahanap natin. Okay? Work together? Ilan? Pag silang lahat daw?
Six hours.
Okay. So, ganito ang representation niya. First pipe, 20 hours. Second pipe, 15. Si third pipe, hindi natin alam. Hahanapin pa. Work together, 6 hours. So, same thing. 1 over 20 plus 1 over 15 since iisang trabaho lang naman yung gagawin nila. Magpuno lang ng pool. Plus 1 over X.
1 over 6.
So, LCD pa rin. Ano po dito? Less common denominator. Ano po?
60.
Okay, 60 divided by 20.
3.
60x kasi may x tayo dyan. Okay, next. 60 divided by 60 4. Divided by 4. X divided by
4 po.
4 po. X. Huwag niyo kalimutan si x. Okay, plus, siyempre makakancel na si x dito, magiging 60. Tama ba? Tama po ba?
Opo. Yes po.
3 plus 4, that is 7x plus 60 over 60x equals 1 over 6. Okay, cross multiply. Ayan, cross multiply. So we now have 6 times 7x plus 60 equals 60x. Tama ba? Okay, so distribute natin. This is 42x plus 6 times 60 is 360. Am I right?
Ma'am, di po makita, ma'am.
Oh. Hindi nyo makita?
Ma'am, yung sa camera po. Pababa po, ma'am.
Pero okay naman, oh. Hmm. Kita na?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. So, ta-transpose lang natin. Lipat natin si 42x sa kabila. Since siya yung mas mababa para magkaroon tayo ng positive is equal to 60x minus 42x. 60x minus 42. Ilan po?
18.
Ha?
18
po. 18? Okay, so we have 18x. Divide both sides by 18 para makuha natin si x. Cancel, cancel. Our x now is equal to?
20.
20 lang. 20. Okay, 20. So 20 hours. So, ibig sabihin, si third pipe, 20 hours siya kumikilos para mabuksan niya yon, ay ma-fill up niya. Okay. So, yan. Checking lang po yan, class. Chinek lang natin kung tama. And tama naman. Okay, next. Ito, try nyo nga to. I will give you 2 minutes lang, ha? Myra takes 2 hours to plant 500 rose bulbs. Francis takes 3 hours to plant 450 rose bulbs. Working together, how long should it take them to plant 1,500 rose bulbs? 2 minutes. Magtatawag ako later on.
Ma'am, paulit nga po ng question. Now.
Ito po yung question. Myra takes 2 hours to plant 500 rose bulbs. Francis takes 3 hours to plant 450 rose bulbs.
2 hours, ma'am, si Francis?
Opo, si Myra po. Si Myra, 2 hours. Si Francis, 3 hours po.
To plant?
To plant 450 rose bulbs.
450?
Yes po.
Oh.
So, working together, how long should it take them to plant 1,500 rose bulbs?
Okay, guys, nasa quest ay nasa chat box po yung mga given. Si Myra, 2 hours, 500 rows. Si Francis, 3 hours, 450 rows. And then, how long will both take kapag magpa-plant sila ng 1,500?
Okay, yan. Pinakita na ni Sir Kenny sa inyo yung representation, ha? It must be easier for you na. Okay, at 10:56, I will call someone para malaman yung kanyang answer. All right. So, I'm hoping may nakatapos na. Meron na po ba? Nag-compute ba kayo? Tahimik na. Busy yata sila nagko-compute. Jewel, what's your answer po? Jewel Alvarez.
Wala pa po, ma'am.
Ha?
Wala pa po. Nagko-compute pa lang po.
Nagko-compute pa lang. Okay. What about Justin? Justin Cesar.
Nagko-compute pa rin po, ma'am.
Okay. Parandom check po ako. Paki-open ng camera and then patingin po ako ng kinocompute ninyo.
Ma'am.
Patingin po. Paki-open ng camera. Yung nagsabing nagpa-compute pa, Jewel and Justin, patingin na po ako ng nagawa ninyo.
₱1.2 po.
So, si Nicole sabi niya ₱1.2. Pare-pareho ba kayo nang nakuha?
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
Pare-pareho po ba nang nakuha? ₱1.2. Hello? Pareho ba hindi? Sir Kenny, what do we do po? Ayaw nilang sumagot.
Pareho po sa akin, ma'am.
Ma'am, nagdalag.
Yung iba? Wala bang iba yung nakuha? Pare-pareho mo? Same. Patingin po ng computation mo, Al Green.
Ma'am, iba po yung akin.
Patingin ako na.
Yung akin.
Hindi ko po napalabas yung 1.2. Ay, 1.2 hours.
Patingin ako lumabas sa'yo. 1.2 rin sa'yo?
Hindi po.
Okay. Patingin ako sa'yo, Christian. Thank you, Al Green. Patingin sa'yo, Christian Cedric.
Ma'am, 8.3 po yung... Ay, 0.83 po yung lumabas sa akin.
Patingin na. 0.83?
Yes po. Ito po, ma'am.
Walang ginabi nyo. Naya, patingin sa'yo, Naya, anak. Thank you, Christian. Ano lumabas sa'yo, Naya?
Nakalap.
Anong lumabas sa'yo?
3.6 po.
3.6. Okay, so almost na yun kay Naya. Alright, so ganito siya, class. So, nirepresent na siya ni Sir Kenny D kanina, ni Sir Kenny. 2 hours kay Myra, 500 bulbs yung naitanim niya. Si Francis naman, 3 hours, 450 bulbs. Okay? Sorry, hindi ko nilagay. Work together. X, okay? Pero 1,500 bulbs, sabi niya, yung dapat na naitanim na nila. Working together. So, ang mangyayari, class, may naka-indicate ng trabaho. Tingnan nyo. May amount of work na kailangan nilang matapos. So, 500 bulbs, 2 hours. Okay? So, yung working time nasa ilalim. Kanina, 1 yung mga ginamit natin kasi isang work po yung ginagawa nila. Okay, walang naka-indicate na kailangan nilang matapos. E dito mayroon. Sabi niya 500 bulbs. Okay? So 500 over 2 plus 450 bulbs in 3 hours equals work together 1,500 bulb po ang kailangan nilang matapos over X kasi wala yung work together nila. Okay? So i-add lang natin. Get the LCD. 6 pong nasa denominator. 6 divided by 2 is 3 times 500, that is 1,500. 6 divided by 3 is 3 times 450, that is 900. I mean 2. 2 times 450, that is 900. So, cross multiply. Okay, ayan. Cross multiply ko na po siya. Naging 900 is equal to 2,400x. Okay, inadd ko na po ito. Tapos pinag-multiply ko na po ito. So 9,000 equals 24x over, divide both sides by 24. So x is 3.75 hours. Si 0.75 hour, kinonvert ko po siya kay minute. Kaya hour x is 3.75 hours or 3 hours 45 minutes. Claro?
Miss Annalyn?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear po ba tayo sa part na yan?
Miss Annalyn?
Yes po.
Pwede pong picturean?
Yes po, pwede po.
I mean, pwede niyo pong picturean kasi po malago po dito sa screen ko.
Ah, okay. Send ko na lang. Kay Sir Ken.
Yes po.
Tapos Sir Ken lang.
Sige po. Thank you po.
Okay. So, clear po ba tayo sa part na to?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes po, ma'am.
So, that ends day 4 and day 5. Now, let's go kay day 7. Okay, day 7 na po tayo. Day 6 is your pitas, so wala po yon. Day 7. So, kay day 7 naman po, we are going to determine the inverse of one-to-one function. And we will try to graph. Okay, so bilisan lang po natin yung inverse. So, pag sinabi mo namang inverse, naiintindihan nyo ba yung term na inverse naman, di ba?
Yes po.
Yes, inverse. Tama po ba?
Yes, ma'am.
Parang mga ganyan, no? Binabaliktad lang yung words. Ang tawag po dyan is palindromes. Palindrome. Okay, so kapag binaliktad mo, pareho pa rin yung word. Back to back. Okay, so what does inverse mean? You already know what inverse is. That is the opposite or the reverse of something. Okay, so what about pagdating naman na sa function? Okay, so when we say one-to-one, papadaliin ko na lang po yung kanyang definition, okay? Pag sinabi mong one-to-one, from the name itself, one-to-one, okay? So, isa pares lang sa isa. Hindi pwedeng isa pares sa marami. Naintindihan?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. Ng one-to-one. When we say one-to-one class, ayan, si X, kailangan paired lang siya kay Y. Hindi pwedeng X sub 1, paired siya kay X sub 1, tapos X sub 2, paired ulit siya kay X sub 1. Hindi pwede. Kailangan may sarili siyang pares. Naintindihan po ba?
So, yes, let's
read here, values of X. Values of X, we have, okay, 6, 3, ito na lang. 6, 3, 7, 2, 7, I mean, 8, 2. 1 to 1 or no? Masabi po ba natin 1 to 1 ito?
Hindi po, kasi
hindi po. Yung 2. No, kasi naulit si?
2.
Kailangan may sarili-sarili po silang value. Nagkakaintindihan?
Yes,
yes
po.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Inverse function class, siya naman po yung kabaligtaran ni one to one. Ang may inverse lang po na function is si one to one. Kapag hindi po yan one to one, hindi nyo po makukuhanan yan ng inverse. Maliwanag?
Yes po.
Okay, and we have here the steps in finding the inverse of one to one function. Ito siya. Okay, so to further understand, let me show you na lang. Alright, so let's have an example. Let's say we're trying to find for the inverse of the function f of x, 2x minus 2. Okay, so first step, f of x po, palitan nyo lang ng letter y. Okay, y is equal to 2x minus 2. Maliwanag.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So, next step, si X at si Y, pagbabaliktarin nyo lang po. Si Y magiging X, and then, si X magiging Y, minus 2. Clear?
Yes, po.
Yes, po.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now we can solve for the value of y using this. Let's solve for the value of y in terms of x. So ito yung gagamitin natin para mahanap si y. So 2y, iwanan na natin si 2y dyan. Si negative 2, transpose natin sa kabila. Okay? So this will become x minus 2. Tama po ba?
Hindi po ba x plus
2? Plus
2, ma'am. Sorry, x plus 2. Thank you. At least na-notice nyo yung pagkakamali. Okay. So that will be x plus 2. Next, we divide both sides by?
2.
2, ma'am.
So our y now is equal to?
X plus 2.
X plus 2 over 2.
Over
2.
2 po. 2
po. Okay. So diba kanina, si f of x pinatan lang natin ng y?
Opo.
So opo. Si y naman ngayon, papaltan natin ng f x. Of negative 1 x. Sorry, masyadong malayo. Dali. F negative 1 x. So, x plus 2 over 2. Ayan na. Ito na yung kanyang inverse. Maliwanag?
Yes po.
Yes, ma'am.
Klaro po.
Klaro po. Okay. So, let's have another example. F of x is equal to x squared minus 9 over 7. First step?
Y.
First step?
Y.
Y is equal to x squared minus 9 over 7. Next step?
Yung x, gawin mo y.
Interchange x with y.
Okay, so magiging x equals
y squared.
Y squared minus 9 over 7. Next.
Transpose the constant.
Okay, so let's try to compute na. Sulat ko ulit. X is y squared minus 9 over 7. Cross multiply, tama ba?
Yes po.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So it's either you can cross multiply or we call this multiply both sides. Pareho lang po yun. You can multiply both sides by 7. Okay, nakita nyo ba? Ayan. Multiply both sides by 7. 7. Oh. Cancel. Cancel. We have 7x is equal to y squared minus
9. Y squared 9. Minus 9.
Next.
7x plus 9 equals y squared.
7x.
7x plus
9. 9.
Y squared.
Y squared.
Okay, now let's extract the root. Okay. Ayan. Ayan. Our y now is equal to?
Ma'am, hindi po makita, ma'am.
Square root of
7x plus
9. Okay, so next is last step.
F negative 1.
F negative 1 of x.
Of x.
Square root of 7x plus
9. Yeah, with the inverse. Ito na po yung kanyang inverse. Clear?
Yes, po.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, how are we going to prep po, ma'am? Okay, actually, napakadali lang mag-prep class. Yan yata ang pinakamadaling gawin sa ano sa pre-calculus, ang mag-graph. Okay? Kapag in college, na sa college ako, pag ayaw kong mag-compute, nag-graph na lang ako para makita ko yung sagot. Okay, so ito siya. Let's try to graph f of x, yung kaninang example natin, 2x minus 2. Let's graph this. So sa pagka-graph class, parang yung sinabi ko kanina sa inyo, sa stat class, magbibigay lang po kayo ng values ni x para makita kung may mauulit pa kay y or wala. Okay, so ang gagawin natin, our x equal to, let's say for example, we have negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, napaka-importante class na marunong po kayong mag-graph. Okay, so dito, pareho lang yan sa y equals 2x minus 2. Okay, so hahanapin natin yung mga values ni y. So, ang gagawin natin, Yung mga values po ni x, sasubstitute lang po natin dito para mahanap si y. Okay, let's try. Negative 3, substitute po natin dito. 2 times negative 3, minus 2.
Negative 8.
Negative 8. 2 times negative minus 2. Answer?
Negative 8.
Dito naman, 2 times
negative 6.
How about here?
Negative 4.
Negative 4. Nakikita niyo na ba yung pattern?
Yes.
Dito, kung na kayo mag-compute, pattern naman.
Negative 2.
Here?
0.
0.
2. 2. Next?
4.
Negative 4.
Let's try to ask muna the questions. May nauulit ba dito sa X?
Wala po.
So, it's a one-to-one function. Paano tayo mag-graph? Madali lang naman mag-graph. I'm sure alam niyo naman mag-graph, no?
Yes.
Tama po ba?
Yes.
O yan.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, po.
Kailangan po natin siya kay X and Y. Okay, so ito si X. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4. And this is 0. Nandito si 0. Okay, so 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Class, depende sa inyo kung anong gusto nyong ilagay dito sa number line, ha? Since even numbers naman si Y, si 2, 4, 6 na lang gagamitin ko, okay?
Yes, po.
10. Negative 2, negative 4, negative 6, negative 8, negative 10. Okay, so pagtapat-tapatin natin. Kapag negative 3, asan si negative 3? Andito. Ang magiging value daw ni y is negative 8. Asan si negative 8?
Nasa baba.
Andito siya. So, kukunin lang po natin yung intersection nung dalawa. So, andito si point. Next, kapag negative 2, asan daw yung pares niya?
Nasa baba po.
Nasa baba.
Kay negative 6.
Negative 6.
Tapatin lang po natin. Ayan. Negative 6. Next, si negative 1, asan ang katapat niya?
Negative 4.
Ito naman, negative 4. Next, kapag 0, asan, dito si 0 ha, asan ang katapat ni 0?
Negative 2.
Antito siya, negative 2. Next, kapag si 1 naman, asan daw yung katapat niya?
0.
0.
1, 0. Kaya andito, wait lang, mali yung graphing natin. Dapat maging ganun yan. Okay, 2, 8, 6, 4, 2. Kasi class, 0, negative 2. Mali tayo. Okay, 0, negative 2. Tama naman. Si 1.
Ma'am, nasa 1 po dapat.
Yes,
nasa
1 po.
Apo.
Andito sa X, okay? Next,
apo.
Si 2.
Sa taas.
Two.
Andito siya sa taas. Okay? Next, si 3.
4.
Andito
pa. 4 po.
Okay, so kapag enough natin yan, sorry ha, medyo balik ko yung drawing ko. Ayan. Basta straight yan, class. Okay, so ganyan siya, yung graphing. So walang naulit. Kapag sinabi mo kasing may nauulit, it's either ganito yung graph niya, class, o ayan. Okay, andito yung point and then may naulit ditong point. So, hindi na to one-to-one. Ito si one-to-one graph. Clear?
Yes,
clear.
Yes,
clear. Don?
None po.
Okay, let's go. So, si day 8 naman, this is finding the intercept. Asymptote and inverse of exponential function. Actually, dapat na only si day 9 kasi day 9 is exponential function. Okay? Pero nauna si day 8, kaya dito muna tayo kay day 8. Okay, so ito siya. Exponential function with base b is a function with the form. Ito naman ang form ni exponential. From the name itself, exponential. So may exponent. Nasa exponent naman siya. Aliwanag?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. So dito class, si b or si base, dapat hindi po siya mag-i-equal kay 1. Bakit kaya? Bakit hindi siya pwedeng equal kay 1? 1 raised to 2. 1. 1 raised to 10. 1 pa rin. Kaya hindi pwede si 1. Kasi kahit na nung erase mo kay 1, magiging 1 pa rin ang sagot. Okay? So, eto naman po siya. Sabi niya, an exponential function has no x-intercept. Bakit wala siyang x-intercept? Hindi niya matatouch si x. Why? Bakit po kaya hindi niya matatouch si x?
Kasi hindi po aabot sa x-axis.
Very good. Kasi nasa taas lang po siya. Either nasa taas or nasa baba. Basta hindi niya, hindi sila mag-aagawan. Okay, parang ganito sa class o kanina. It's either nandito siya or nandito. Hindi sila mag-aagawan na katulad nito. Hindi sila nagko-crossover. Parang, oh, territory ko to. Territory mo yan. Bawal ang anuhan. Okay? May border sila. Border nila sa X. Maliwanag?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So, here we have the inverse of exponential function. So, mag-involve na po si logarithm. Okay, so let's have here, let's try to find, how are we going to find the y-intercept? Since walang ang x-intercept, si y-intercept lang po. Class, always and always, ang asymptote po niya is 0. Kasi kay hanggang kay y lang po siya. Okay, so hindi niya matatouch si y. Alright, so y is equal to, I mean, sorry, for y-intercept, okay, since hindi niya matatouch si x, dito lang po tayo kay y. So to get y-intercept, ano ang representation natin kay y-intercept? That is? 0y. Okay. Pero dito, class, ang gagawin lang po natin, 0y. Okay. So, ang gagawin po natin dito para makuha natin, let's say, for example, we have 3x plus 2. So, napansin nyo, whole number po si base. Nasa taas si variable, naka-exponent. Ito yung tinatawag natin exponential function. Nasa exponent kasi siya. Okay. So, to get that, si x po, i-equate natin kay 0. Tama ba? Kasi si x dito is equal to 0. Ayan siya o 0 siya. Okay, so f of 0 is equal to 3 raised to our x is 0. 0 plus 2. So f of 0 is equal to 3 raised to 2. Okay, or pwede natin itong palitan ng y and that will become
9.
Okay, y-intercept now is 0, 9. So, ibig sabihin, tama siya kay 9. Kay y-axis. Paliwanag?
Opo.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So, how do we look for the inverse? Paano naman po natin hahanapin si inverse? Okay, so same example, 3, f of x equal to 3 raised to x plus 2. So, to get the inverse, class, ang gagawin lang po natin, first, i-equate natin to kay y. Okay? Y is equal to 3 raised to x plus 2. Di ba parang ganito rin yung ginawa natin kanina? Tama ba?
Yes.
Okay, next. Same lang din, pagpapalitin po natin si y at saka si x. So, this will become x is equal to 3 raised to y plus 2. Okay? Remember? Ganyan din po yung ginawa natin. Okay, next. Ang gagawin po natin, ang base natin is 3. Tama po ba?
Opo.
Yes, tama. So, dadagdagan po natin siya ng logarithm with the base. Okay? Both sides. So, logarithm with base 3 x is equal to logarithm base 3 to 3y plus 2. Okay? So, ito siya. If you remember, wala pa kasi. Nasa day 9 kasi yung loss of logarithm class. Okay, so kapag nasa exponent siya, ang gagawin nyo po, ililipat nyo po ito. Okay, malilipat po siya dito sa unahan. Later on, makikita nyo sa loss of logarithm, nahuli kasi siya, dapat yun muna. Okay, base 3x is equal to y plus 2
log 3
times log 3 with a base 3. Lahat ng logarithm class with the same base, just like this one, logarithm 3 with a base 3, equal na po yan kay 1.
1.
Lahat po ng ganyan, mag-equal kay 1. Okay, so we have here logarithm of x with a base 3 is equal to y plus 2 times 1. Oh, same pa rin, magiging ganito rin lang po yan, y plus 2. Okay? So, ang mangyayari, logarithm of 3, I mean of x with base 3 is equal to y plus 2. To get y, ano pong gagawin natin? We
transpose.
Okay, so we have now logarithm of x with base 3. Okay, ilagyan nyo yun ng parenthesis kasi silang magkasama, minus 2. This is now the inverse of this exponential function. So we have now here f of negative 1, f negative 1 of x is equal to logarithm of x with a base 3 minus 2. Ito na po siya. Maliwanag?
Yes,
maliwanag po ba? Okay, so si asymptote, always and always, y is 0. Hindi nyo na kailangan mag-compute. Ayan na po, y is equal to 0 si asymptote. Clear?
Opo.
Opo.
So, sandali lang. Usap lang kami sa teacher Kenny for day 9. We're moving on to day 9. Wait lang, class, ha? Do you want another example? Kay exponential?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so let's say we have here f of x is equal to, I will check your ano, your module para makita yung iba pang examples here na pwede nating i-compute. Let's have 2, ito na lang, 3 raised to, ay hindi, huwag naman 3, 3 ulit, f of x is equal to 8 raised to 2x, ito naman tayo. 8 raised to 2x. Let's try to find the asymptote. Asymptote? Anong asymptote dito?
Zero.
Zero, ma'am.
Zero. Wag lang zero. Y is equal to zero.
Zero, zero.
Okay. Next, y-intercept.
Y is equal to one.
Y-intercept.
One.
Is equal
to
one. Y. Okay, let's look at that.
64.
This is
1.
Y is equal to 8 raised to
0.
2 times 0.
Zero.
Y is
1.
Very 8 raised to 0 is 1. Any number raised to 0 will always be equal to 1. Okay, next. Inverse. Don't type inverse. Okay, so let's write it again. 8 raised to 2x. First step.
Y is equal to.
Y is equal to.
8
raised to 2x. Next.
X.
Next is 8 raised to.
2y.
Next.
Y.
Anong next?
Logarithm of 8.
Okay, so logarithm of x with base 8 is equal to
2y.
Exponent one. Plus pat natin para maiwan tong dalawang to lang.
1.
Square root of 8 with base 8. Ayan, siya na lang iwan. If automatic if tie.
1.
And now left with logarithm of x with base 8. 2y. At yung 1. May mali po. Okay, so 1. So divide both sides by?
2.
Ayan, cancel. Y is equal to
logarithm
over 2. So, our inverse function is now equal to logarithm of x base 8 over 2. Ayan na po. Clear?
Yes, po.
Yes, ma'am. Alright, so let's okay, let's go to day 9. Okay, so for day 9 class, we're going to solve and graph exponential function. Magka-graph na po tayo. Alright. So ito yung ating exponential. Let A A class is the base. Ha? Huwag kayong malilito. Si base po yan. Ito po yung sinasabi ko sa inyo kanina. These are the laws of exponential. Okay? So, if you can see, kapag same base po yan with different exponents, i-add nyo lang po yung exponent. Multiplication po yan, ha? Okay? Next, pag division, minus nyo lang. Kapag multiplication, kapag yung dalawang exponents ang minumultiply, okay, mamultiply nyo lang po yan. Pag ganito naman, sa distribution, okay, same with this. Okay, let's have examples here para mas makita nyo. Let's say 2 raised to 7 times 2 raised to 3. Ano magiging sagot po dyan?
2 raised to 10.
2 raised to 10. 11. 4 raised to 10. That will become 2 raised to?
4 raised 10. 10.
2 raised to 10. Okay. So, pag ganito naman, 2 raised to 7 divided by 2 raised to 3, ang mangyayari, that will become 2 raised to?
4. 7 minus
3. 2 raised to 4. Kapag trinay yung yan class, sa calculator, pareho lang pong kalalabasan. Kapag nagmano-mano kayo, tsaka ito, mga shortcuts lang po ito. Next, let's say 2 raised to 7 raised to 3. This will become 2 raised to
21.
7 times 3.
And that is 2 raised to
21.
Okay. 2 times 6 raised to 3, equal lang po yan sa 2 raised to 3
times 6 raised to 3.
O, pag sinanong nyo yan, okay na yan. 2x raised to 7. This will become 2 raised to 7 times x raised to 7. Okay, nag-distribute lang po tayo. Distribute lang. Next, same lang din po yan sa division. Let's say we have 2 over x raised to 7. So, magiging 2 raised to 7 over x raised to 7. Paliwanag?
Yes, ma'am.
Klaro po pa?
Klaro po.
Okay. So, yes, how are we going to solve for x kapag naka-exponential siya? Let's say we have 2 raised to 7x plus 1 equal to 32. Okay. So, paano yan? Ala, paano natin ito i-compute? Paano hanapin si x? O, nagpanik na.
Okay? Divided.
So, baka sabihin nyo, oh, divide both sides by 7x plus 1. No. Okay? Si 32 ba pwede natin siyang i-exponential form?
Yes po.
Yes po.
Yes. With base 2.
Yes po.
mag-isip kayo ng pwedeng exponents ni 2 na kapag minultiply, multiply, multiply, magiging 32. Pwede ba?
2 is
4.
4.
Plus 1 is equal to, try nga natin. Dapat pareho sila ng base, ha? 2 raised to 4. That is 16 lang.
5 po.
5 po.
3 raised to 5. I mean, 2 raised to 5 is 32. So, pwede. So, 2 raised to 5. Ayan. 2 raised to 5. Kailangan pareho po sila ng base. Okay? Same base dapat. Next, pwede na natin i-compute si x. 7x plus 1 equal to 5. Ayan na. Okay? So, 7x equal to 5 minus 1. Transpose lang po natin si 1. So, 7x is equal to 4. Divide both sides by 7. 7x now is equal to 4 over 7.
4 over 7. Here we have it, ladies.
Tapos na. Ganyan lang po, class. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Wala nang question dito?
Wala na po.
Wala na. Okay, let's go naman sa mga inequality. When we say inequality class, hindi sila equal. Dito gumagamit sila ng equal. Dito naman, hindi tayo gagamit ng equal sign. Okay, kay inequalities, wait lang. Inequality. Ha, ano to? By inequality, we use greater than or less than. Okay? Okay po ba?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yung nauna kanina. 2 raised to 7x plus 1 is less than 32. Okay, so paano po ang gagawin natin? Okay, same pa rin. Kailangan same base. Plus 1 less than 2 raised to
5.
2 raised to 5, tama?
Yes po.
Okay, so 7x, huwag kayong mag-move class ha. I mean, huwag kayong maglilipat-lipat. Kailangan same yung position. Kung nandito siya, dito pa rin. Baka ilipat nyo. Okay, so dito, si 1 pa rin pong ilipat natin. 7x is less than 5 minus 1. Okay, so 7x is less than 4 divided by 7. 7. So x is less than 4 over 7. Okay? So, 4 over 7 po siya. So, ang mangyayari, ang solution set po natin dyan, kapag nakaturo po siya kay x, ang magiging solution set po natin is
negative.
4 over 7 negative infinity. Okay?
Ma'am, di po ba mauna yung negative infinity po?
Class, si X po siya.
Okay po, ma'am.
Okay po ba?
Yes, ma'am.
Another example?
Isa pa po.
Yes po, ma'am.
Isa pa po, ma'am.
Okay. Wait lang, kuha pa tayo ng isa pang example. Wait, let me look for another example. Last topic of the day na po ito. Let's say this one. Yung example sa inyong TG. Okay lang ba yung example sa TG ninyo? Ang gamitin natin? Class? Hello?
Okay lang po.
Okay. Okay so, let's give 3 raised to x is less than 9 raised to x minus 2. Okay, same base na ba sila?
Hindi pa po.
Hindi pa ma.
So, hindi pa sila same base. So, ang gagawin natin, pagparehoin natin ang base. 3 raised to a, x is less than, anong pwedeng base ni 9?
3 squared.
3 squared.
2 times x minus 2. Okay, 3 squared. Multiply pa rin siya dito ha. Okay. X is less than 2 times x minus 2. Okay, so x now is less than distribute 2x minus 4. Kung nasan yung mas malaki class, doon nyo siya ililipat. Hindi naman pwede ilipat natin to kasi magiging negative. Okay? So, same pa rin. Siyang ilipat natin. 2x minus x magiging positive 4. Tama ba?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, po.
Okay. Now, it's greater than 4. Since nakabuka ka po siya kay x, paano ba? O, tama. Ganun nga. Para mas matandaan nyo. Okay. So, since mas malaki siya, x is greater, ang gagawin nyo po dito magiging 4. Ang palis po niya is positive infinity. Okay? Kapag mas maliit si x, negative infinity. Kapag mas malaki si x, positive infinity. Maliwanag? Maliwanag?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Should we have another example? This is the last part of our discussion. Another
yes,
example
ma'am. Yung may fraction, ma'am.
Yung may fraction. Okay. Ito, sige. I will give you something with a fraction. Wala akong makitang fraction. Oy. Ito na lang. 1/2 raised to x plus 2. Less than 1/4 raised to 2x. Okay? Ganyan ba yung hinahanap yung example?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Ma'am. Okay, so anong mangyayari dito? 1/2, ito. 1/2 raised to x plus 2 is less than, saan natin ito pwedeng erase? Si 1/4. Dapat two same base.
Raised to
4. 1/2 tuloy. 1/2 pa rin, tama? 1/2 raised to 2. Let's try sa calculator. 1/2 is squared. Tignan lang natin kung tama. Oh, 1/4 pa rin. Okay, so pwede. Raised to 2 times 2x. Okay, so pwede na? Same base na?
Yes.
X plus 2 is less than 2 times 2x.
2 times 2x.
Okay, so this one now is x plus 2 less than 4x. 4x. Sino ilipat natin? Si 4x or si x?
Si x.
Ilipat nyo si x. Okay, so 4x minus x, that is 2.
3.
Okay, so 2 less than, ano dito?
3x.
3x. Divide both sides by 3.
2.
3. So 2/3 is less than x. Anong magiging solution set natin dito?
2/3.
2/3.
Positive infinity.
Infinity class. Basta pag binubukakaan niya si x, positive infinity po yun. Okay? Kapag tinuturo niya si x, negative infinity. Maliwanag?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Any other question?
Ma'am, pwede isa pang ano?
Oh, sige. Ito pa.
Pero yung whole number po tsaka fraction.
What do you mean class? Paano yun magpapareho class kung fraction yung isa tas whole number yung isa?
Ma'am, may na-encounter po akong problem na ganun sa module.
Okay, so sabihan din si 1 over 100. Ay, wait lang. Equals sign. Nakikita ko dito. Equal sign naman po class. Ang nakikita ko. Walang ano fraction na sa inequality. Patingin na ko nung na-encounter mo.
Ano po pala yun sa equal sign
po? Oh, diba? Sa equal lang siya. Wala siya sa inequality. Kasi paano mo pagpapala? Oh, sige. Sa equal sign tayo. Gusto niyo sa equal?
Opo.
Opo, ma'am.
Equals 100x. Baka nalilito kasi kayo kung paano, no? Ito. I'm going to solve for x. Okay. So, paano to? Paano to, class? That is 1 over 10 raised to 10 squared. 10 squared ba?
2.
Ma'am,
2. 2, di ba?
Apo.
So, ang mangyayari, nasa ilalim siya, tama?
Apo.
So, ang gagawin niyo dyan, class, mapupunta lang po siya sa taas, pero magiging negative po yan. Magiging negative 2 is equal to 10 raised to x. Kahit itry po natin sa calculator. 10 raised to negative 2. See? That is equal to 1 over 100. Tama?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so there you have it, ladies. Our x is equal to negative 2. Okay, ang idea lang naman kasi nito class is kailangan kung ano yung nandito, papareho siya dito. Okay, anong ilalagay mo kay x para maging 1 over 100 yan? Okay, pwede mo bang ilagay dyan si 2? No, kasi magiging 100 lang siya. Para maging fraction, kailangan maglagay ka ng negative exponent para maging fraction siya. Alright?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. Any more question?
Is Annalyn?
Yes po. Sino yun? Ay, si Daniel. Okay, yes po.
Is Annalyn, medyo nalilito po ako sa pagta-transpose. Paano po nalaman kung sino ang ililipat?
Ililipat mo na kasi mas mababa. Just like
example
here.
Po.
Just like here. Sinong mas mababa? Si X or si 4X?
Si X po.
Si X. Since mas mababa si X, siya po ang ilipat mo. Okay? Para hindi, okay. Hindi kasi pwedeng negative X ang lumabas dito. Kailangan positive X.
Sige po. Thank you po.
Actually, pareho lang class, okay? Pakitaan ko kayo ha. Let's say x is x plus 2 is less than 4x. Tignan nyo, ganito rin lang ang mangyayari dyan. Class. Let's say ang pinagpalit nyo is si 4x. So, x minus 4x.
Negative 2.
Oh, tama. Less than negative 2. Tama?
Yes, ma'am po.
Ay, sorry. Ano nangyari sa screen ko? Ayan. So, ang mangyayari dyan, syempre, magiging negative 3x less than negative 2.
Negative 2.
Okay? Divide.
Negative 3.
Negative 3. Your x is?
2/3.
Sorry. 2/3. Tignan nyo, maiiba na siya. Okay.
Thank you for letting me channel.
Na yung support. Right? Kung mag-stay put po kayo dito. Okay,
ma'am, next tanong po ako.
Ma'am. Yes po. Yes po.
Ma'am Annalyn, may tanong po ako.
Pwede yes po.
Magbigay po kayo ng examples of greater than or equal to or less
greater
than.
Greater than or equal to.
Opo.
Para wala lang yung class. Okay, ito. I will give you example. See? Yung nasa tigi ninyo yung gamitin natin kasi may nakita ko dito. 3x minus 1 greater than or equal ay 1, 2, 5, 3x plus 5. Okay, kikita nyo ba? Nakikita po?
Hindi po.
Ay, sorry. Ayan. So, si 1, 2, 5 tsaka si 25, anong pwede maging base nila?
5 raised to 2.
5 squared dito, 3x minus 1, less than equal, 5 raised to
3.
Ilan dito? 3. 3x plus 5. Okay. So, same base na. So, 2 times 3x minus 1, less than or equal to 3 times 3x plus 5. Okay. Distribute 6x minus 2, tama ba? Less than equal 9x plus 15. Am I right?
Yes po, ma'am.
15. Okay. So, greater than equal. Sino ilipat natin? Si 6x. Minus 6x. Dito, negative 2 minus 15. Okay. So, greater than equal. 9x minus 6x. That is 3x. And this one is negative 17. Divide both sides by 3. By 3. So greater than equal x negative 17 over 3. Anong magiging solution set natin dyan? That is negative 17 over 3 and
positive infinity.
Positive infinity. Ayan. Same lang din po siya, class. Basta may inequality.
Ma'am, may tanong po ako, ma'am.
Yes po.
Medyo nalilito po ko po ako dun sa ano. Paano po ma-determine if positive infinity or negative infinity po, ma'am?
Class, kapag nakabuka ka siya kay x, positive infinity. Kapag nakaturo siya kay x, negative infinity. Maliwanag?
Thank you po, ma'am.
Itong si x, hindi nyo pwedeng baguhin yan. Kasi ayan, may palyo nga si x. Si y ang wala. I-ordered pair po yan. Solution set siya. Okay?
Thank you po, ma'am.
Alright. Any question pa po?
Ma'am, positive.
Yes po.
Yung positive infinity po, tapos yung negative infinity, does it have a certain place dun sa solution set?
Does yung, it have
kapag, kapag negative infinity po siya, does it have to be on the right side of the solution set or on the left side po?
Nandito po siya, class, kasi siya yung values ni y. Do you get the point? May value tayo ng x. Okay, so anong magiging value ni y? Okay, so siya yung, ito siya. So kaya nandito po siya sa right side. At nasa left side si x. Alright?
Okay po, ma'am. Thank you po.
Kasi kung baga, class, ang gusto niyang sabihin, ang mga magiging kapares po ni negative 17 over 3 ay si positive 1, 2, y is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, hanggang sa dulo ng walang hanggan. Yun po yung gusto niyang sabihin. Maliwanag?
Yes, clear? Po,
yes. Okay. Any other question po? Sa graphings naman, sa pagga-graph po, pareho lang po yung gagawin natin. Same sa ginawa natin kanina. Let's say, for example, g of x is equal to 2 raised to x. So, ang mangyayari, magbibigay lang po tayo ng values ni x. Let's say, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2. So, anong magiging values ni y? Papalitan nyo lang po ito ng y raised to 2x. Then, sa substitute lang po natin. 2 raised to negative 2. 2 raised to negative 2 po.
Positive 4.
2 raised to negative 2. Class, negative po yung exponent niya. So, for sure, fraction po yan.
Negative
1/4.
1/4?
1/4. Plus, basta negative exponent, fraction po ang kalalabasan yan. Okay, next. 2 raised to negative 1.
1/2 po.
1/2. 2 raised to 0.
1.
2 raised to 1.
2.
2. 2 raised to 2.
4.
Alright. So, sa pagka-graph, ganun lang din po sa ginawa natin kanina. Ayan. Okay. We have 1, 2, 3. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. And we have 1, 2. Lumalabo yung aking camera. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, we have here 1, 2, 3. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So, kapag negative 2, nasaan siya kay 1/4? So, might be, nandito lang siya. Let's say, ito yung 1/2. Ito yung 1/4. Okay? So, andito siya. Right? Kapag negative 1 siya, nasaan daw po siya? Nakay 1/2. So, andito siya. Kapag 0, nakay 1. Okay, andito si 0. 0 si x. Andito si y. 1 siya. Kapag 1 na kay 2. Kapag 2 na kay 4. Okay, so ang graph niya is pag ganito. Sorry, klase na nagkata. Okay, so ganyan po ang graph niya. Tingnan nyo, hindi niya matatouch si X. Andito yung ano niya, oh. Hindi po niya yan matatouch. Maliwanag?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so ganyan po yung graphings niya. Si exponential. It's either pa ganyan or pa ganyan. Okay? Clear?
Clear po.
And that ends our discussion class, day 4 to day 9.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
We're done. I hope you learned something today. Clear po ba yung naging discussion natin?
Yes po, ma'am. Thank you po.
Yes po, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Thank you po. Nagbago
kayo, ma'am. Ma'am, isa-send niyo po ba yung solution?
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes po, isa-send po ni ma'am.
Thank you po.
Isi-send po ni ma'am sa akin, tapos isi-send ko po sa mga GCs. Okay.
Thank you po, okay. Sir Kenny.
Thank you, Sir Kenny.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye.
Okay, class. Thank you, teachers. Have a great day.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, kids. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Sir and ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir, ma'am.
Sorry, guys. Sir, can I still ask a question?